Hi, Joan Hyman here.
Hi.
And with my partner Fitzjoy Helen and our little puppy. So today's class is going to be pranayama and restoratives with some meditation. It's very important that we use this time, this quarantine time, to go in right now and do some deep healing, especially as a collective, and really work towards raising the consciousness. If we're operating from a fear-based place, we will react from that fear-based place. And this could also create a lot of self-destructive behavior. So part of the reason why I'm putting out these free videos is so that we can spread the benefits of practice, getting quiet, going inwards, and use this time to elevate consciousness. And as a collective, expand our own consciousness so we can come together and really do some deep healing during this time. Okay, so you will need props. You'll need a bolster, two blocks, a strap, and blankets. If you don't have props, just get creative, look around your house, and please pass this video on to anyone that needs some calming down right now, okay? So I'm gonna use my partner, Fitzjoy.
We'll see.
And we're going to start in a restorative called Supta Baddha Konasana, okay? And make sure you have a quiet place that you can do your practice at. All right, so go ahead and Fitzjoy, lie down on the bolster. And you can see the bolster, it's vertical. And we'll use this red bolster, okay? And then, we'll use the brown bolster. And go ahead and lie down. We'll actually just sit close to the bolster. And so I have one blanket at the back of the bolster for his head. And then Fitzjoy, bring the soles of the feet together.
Is it the bolster?
Yeah.
Bolster.
Our little puppy. All right, go ahead and bring the soles of the feet together and sit up first, okay? So the strap is really open like this. And I'm gonna put the strap on his back, the lowest part of the back, and then strap it around the outer ankles. Now, because I'm putting him in the strap, the buckle's facing me. But if he were to put himself in this pose, the buckle would face him. And you want to really pull on it so it's quite firm. And then go ahead, Fitzjoy, lie down. And I'm going to grab two blankets. So each blanket, so when it's like this, it's called a shoulder stand blanket. And it's a good place to work from with the blanket. So you'll roll it up just like a little log like this. And I'll put one under each thigh, okay? And then I'll do the same with this, okay? And you wanna be meticulous. So I do suggest if you're at home doing this on your own to have all the props set up and near you. So when you go in, you can go ahead and turn your palms up. Yeah, you can just snuggle everything in. And then with your shoulders, take a moment to roll your inner arm up towards the ceiling and let the shoulder head, let it descend. You are so tall. Okay, so my boyfriend is quite tall and I think I'm gonna actually need another bolster behind him. So go ahead and lift up and release. I'm gonna grab one more blanket. Okay, and go ahead one more time, lift your head and release. And how does that feel? So what we're looking is that the forehead is higher than the chin. And our little puppy loves to crawl into all these cute little spots here. So then I'm gonna grab an eye pillow, or if you don't have an eye pillow, you can use a towel. And go ahead and let the eye pillow or the towel rest on the head, okay? All right, so we'll be here for 10 minutes. So make sure that you are completely set up in a way where you can let yourself drop and just move away from all external stimulation. Okay. So go ahead and take any last adjustments. So you're a little bit more comfortable. Come here, little one. And then take a deep breath in and a long exhale. One more time. Deep breath in and a long exhale. And then just start to observe. Observe that heaviness around your eyes, especially especially if you have an eye pillow. And just this idea of weight, helping the eyes to close even deeper. So they'll feel like they're becoming sealed shut. And just taking this time to look inwards. Relax the space right above the eyes. So the area above the forehead where the thinking lines are, let that area relax, let it soften, and let it spread. So the area around the forehead, this is where our thinking lines are. See if you can just let the thoughts dissolve, coming into a place that's quieter or sitting behind the screen of the mind. So as the thoughts come in, just observe them and allow them to pass, not to get hooked on one particular thought. And as you begin to relax the area above the eyebrows, soften through the temples, into the jaw, let the jaw unhinge, and allow the corners of the lips to slightly part. And then soften and allow the tongue to spread in the mouth. And the upper palate and the back of the mouth to release. And notice the throat, the walls of your throat. So as we begin to move into the relaxation response, it's very normal for the walls of the throat to moisten, for more moisture to build in the mouth. And as you soften the walls of the throat, observe the collarbone region, and even into the back of the neck. This could be a really common place to hold tension around the neck and shoulders. So as you bring your awareness into these places, a lot of times just by noticing, the tension can subside. And allow your right shoulder to become heavy. Let your right arm drop towards the floor, all the way down into the lower arms of the forearms, into the smaller bones of the wrists, into the hands, and into each finger, the thumb, index, middle, ring, and pinky. And just let the whole right arm into the hand and fingers, let it relax. And bring your awareness into the left arm, into the left shoulder head, into the upper arm bone, and down into the two lower arm bones, into the wrist, very small bones of the hands, and into the fingers, into the thumb, index, middle, ring, and pinky. Let the whole left arm down into the left wrist area, let it relax. And then bring your awareness into your chest. And just notice this open feeling along the chest, through the collarbones, as the shoulder heads continue to fall towards the floor. And relax deep into your abdomen. So as you exhale, just notice the softening and the way the belly receives the breath. Observe the pelvis. And the pelvis, which creates this container for our organs, our reproductive organs. So letting the hips relax, starting with the buttock region, allow the buttocks to spread towards the floor. Letting the right hip descend, the right thigh bone to become heavy. So all the strong muscles around the thigh continue to loosen their grip. Relax down into your lower leg, into the ankle bone, and into the sole of the foot. So once again, your right toes, the big toe, second, third, fourth, and fifth. Let it Let the whole right leg drop. And then bring your awareness into the left hip, softening the gluteals, into the strong muscles of the upper thigh, down into the knee, the lower leg, into the ankle, into the small muscles that make up the foot, the small bones, and into the big toe, second, third, fourth, and fifth. Let the entire left foot relax. And now observe your whole body. Perhaps observing your front body melting towards your back body. The back body spreading against the bolster, against the tops. Observe your breath. Your breath gently moving in and out. A very continuous feel and a very subtle energy. And just taking this time to notice the gentleness of your breath, the very fluid nature, its continuous nature. And then start to inhale a little deeper. So there's a gradual pause at the top of the breath. As you exhale, try to pause at the base of the exhale. So there's a gradual pause at the base of the exhale. A true emptying out. And then take your time. So inhale slowly, filling up from the pelvis, through the side ribs, top of the chest, holding. And then exhale slow from the top chest, through the side ribs, out through the abdomen and the pelvis. And continue. So just gradually building the length of the breath. Inhale, filling up all four parts of the ribs, pause. And then exhale, slowly let it descend. Notice the deflation of the rib cage, the softening of the belly, and the emptying out that happens. And then repeat this three more times. So inhale, slowly breathing in to all four sides of the torso. And exhale, even slower, dropping the breath close to the back body and all the way out through the pelvic floor. Two more times. Inhale slow. Hold at the top. And exhale even slower. One more time. Inhale. And exhale. And then just let yourself do nothing. If your mind wanders, let it. Let the breath find its natural pace. We'll be here for about one more minute. Just perhaps observe your whole body. It's much more relaxed, much more still. back to your breath. Gently begin to wiggle your fingertips. Bring one hand to your heart, one hand to your belly. And take another deeper breath. And I'm going to loosen the strap. If you're at home by yourself, just go ahead and loosen the buckle. And then hold your legs and gently bring the feet onto the floor. Good. And roll over to your right arm. And you can turn and rest on the bolster if you like. Just go slow. It's been a full 10 minutes. And then very slowly begin to press yourself. So sweet, right? So the next, I would like to do Setu Bandha Sarvangasana. So if you only have a block at home, Fitzgerald, can you just show this? So we'll work with the props here. So for those of you that have a lot of props like us, in a moment I will show this setup. And Fitz, go ahead and just lay on your back and put the block under your sacrum. And so it doesn't have to be super high, but we're opening the front body now. But lay down first. Yeah, and then bend your knees and come into bridge. And we'll slide the block under. Okay, so this is option one, all right? Now option two, go ahead and lift your hips. And then slowly release and roll down. Okay, now roll over to your side and press yourself up. Okay, so we have two bolsters, and it is nice if you can put the two bolsters so they stack up. And Fitzgerald, just move over a little bit to the side. Okay, so I'm going to put this bolster towards the back of the mat. I'm going to put this bolster here so it creates this one big bolster. And I often find, especially if you have lower back problems, where your hip flexors are tight, to put another blanket flat on the behind the top bolster. Now, if you only have one bolster, you can put a block here or blankets for your feet to rest. And you can always stack up the two blankets like that. Okay? All right, so Fitzgerald, have a seat on the bolster. And then he's gonna lie down. So the bottom tips of the shoulder blades are on the edge of the blanket. The arms are on the floor. And do you have enough room to slide down a little bit more? A little bit more, maybe?
Nope.
Okay, so I'm going to...
It's the wall.
Is your shoulders flat?
Nope.
Okay, so roll over to the side. I'm going to move it down a little. Yeah. Okay. And then go ahead and try it again. Yeah, so you might have to adjust. That's the one thing about restoratives. You have to try to work them a couple times. Okay, and then slide all the way down so your head is close to the wall. Good. All right. And I'm going to get one more blanket for under your legs. So go ahead and lift your feet up. And so if you do have a tighter lower back, put another blanket over the block or the bolster and lift your feet up. And then the strap will go right here, okay? Now, how does that feel, Fitzgerald?
Tied in.
Good. All right, and if you want, you can take your arms out to the side.
Okay. Keep the fire pillow on.
Yeah, where is the eye pillow? Well, we have an eye pillow.
This for the puppy, probably?
I hope not. All right, so go ahead and settle in. No, she's sleeping. It's okay, hopefully it'll show up again. You had it, right?
Good.
All right. Find your breath. It's all right. Turn your palms up. Good. And then just as you start to settle in.
Where's she sleeping?
In the sun right there. Take a few long breaths. Here's the eye pillow. Just to let yourself ease your way in to this different shape. Okay. Try to keep the shoulder heads pressed downwards. So taking this time to snuggle the shoulder blades away from the ears and in towards the chest. And then just continue to observe the softness of your breathing. And even taking a moment to observe the quality of your breath. Unlike the physical body, which has a tendency to be dense, a little thicker, well, a lot thicker, heavy, but heavy in a very grounded way, like our bones. The breath and the subtle body, they move in a much more liquid, fluid way. So the energy is more soft, it's thin, it's fast. And just continue to connect to that light quality the breath can offer. So once again, let your mind continue to rest. And as the thoughts come, which they do, continue to choose to be unhooked, taking your awareness into a deeper place that resides in a more connected way. Let your heart space receive. When we get quiet, it makes it easy to listen to our hearts, to be in that energy that comes from love and more awareness. subtle sounds around the room. Wiggle your toes. I'm going to slip your feet out of the strap. Grab Benjamin's. Just pause here. And then very gently roll over to your right. And you're welcome to scooch back and lie on the bolster. And then gently, gently press yourself up. Some puppy love. All right, and I'm going to move the bolster. So if you're not used to sitting up for long periods of time, like even just over 10 minutes, go ahead and put the bolster close to the wall. And if your hips are tight, you may need another blanket on top of the bolster. So go ahead, Fitzjoy, have a seat on the blanket and the bolster.
What do we do?
Cross-legged position. So I'm going to show you his way and then my way. And we're going to take Nadi Shodhana, which is alternate nostril breathing. So I'm putting a block at his thoracic to help him stay up nice, to help him sit up tall and keep the thoracic spine in. Okay. Thank you. And then I'm going to sit in a different pose. So this is for those of you that don't have a wall, or if your hips are a little bit more open, okay. I'm going to sit in a pose called Siddhasana. Okay. And we're gonna do some even breathing and move into a practice that's called alternated nostril breathing, Nadi Shodhana, okay? So go ahead and let's turn the palms up. Touch your thumb and index finger. So this is Jnana Mudra, the mudra of wisdom, internal wisdom. And extending the other three fingers. And if you're at the wall with the block, gently move your thoracic, your upper back in towards the block to create this stacking. Head over the pelvis, shoulders over the pelvis. And then spread the collarbones wide, lifting the top of the sternum. So just take a moment to find your seat, whatever that looks like for you. Okay, if your hips are tight, you're welcome to sit on a chair, but try to keep your spine upright. And then just begin to observe the softening of the eyebrows, the softening of resistance. And that could also mean softening the thinking lines along the forehead, above the eyebrows. So you're moving into a more receptive place. A more open place. Let the corners of the eyes melt down into the tongue and the jaw. And perhaps even just observe subtle sounds around the room, outside the room. I'm sure it's quiet in most places. So see if you can just begin to hear the light breeze, birds chirping. Just take note, what are the sounds? And begin to slowly deepen your breath, just like you did when you were lying on the bolster. So this wave-like breath. Starting at the base of the exhale, pause, ground the sit bones. And then inhale, filling up gradually. Bringing the breath into all four parts of the ribs, pausing at the top. And then exhale, slow. Emptying the breath, drawing the navel in, and pausing. Repeating, inhale. Hold, Exhale. Draw the navel up as you exhale, pause at the base. Inhale again, gradually filling up. Try to breathe into the upper back and then the chest, pause, hold. And exhale slow. Trying to keep the connection to lifting the navel, the pelvic floor, abdomen, pause, belly hollows. Repeating again, slow, inhale. Hold. Exhale. Okay, and at the base of your next exhale, pause. And take three more on your own. So try to keep the breath even. The pauses are about a second or two. And the key is that there's no strain. It should feel fluid. It should feel easy and natural. Just deepening the connection to your inner body, your inner space. And last cycle. And then just let yourself find some natural breaths. Slip into a place where you're being more of the observer. In the practice of yoga, we call this space viveka, discernment, where we're not in the reactive mind. This is the place where we're residing from a much higher place of consciousness. There's a deep trust and a sense of getting rooted in our body that has to happen to reside in this place. We'll move into alternated nostril breathing. So if you're unfamiliar with this, just open your eyes for a moment. And if you know this, keep your eyes closed. So let's go ahead and lift your right arm and take your peace fingers, your middle and your middle finger and your pointer finger, and close them. So your fourth and your thumb will be in front of your nostrils. And then inhale through both nostrils. Close the tip of the left, exhale right. And pause at the base. Inhale right. Hold it. Exhale left. Inhale left. Hold, exhale right, inhale right, hold, and when hold it, hug into the central channel, your midline, exhale left. Hold, hug in, find that center line. Exhale right. Okay, so continue. That was two cycles. Take three more on your own. And just like before, the key is no strain. So think of breathing through the right side. You'll hug and you're holding into the area right in front of the spine. That's also known as the Sushumna Nadi, the central nadi, where all of the major energy runs through. And then you'll exhale, breathe through the left side of the body. Let the pauses be significant. And try not to overdo it, okay? So two more cycles. When you're done, just let your hands relax, sitting quietly, just continue to observe this connection to your breath, and also the connection to your body. The breath helps us to ground our attention, stay in our body. Perhaps even notice your mind in a more quiet place. Softly blinking your eyes open, just look down towards the floor and raise your gaze. Okay, so we're going to lay on our back, we're going to continue the pranayama. Go ahead. So cute. I'll take the block out. Good girl. Oh, she loves her daddy. Oh, daddy's energy is so calming. Okay, so now we're going to take the blanket, and this is called a threefold, and it's a supported pranayama setup. So the blanket will start like this, and it folds one, two, three, okay, like an accordion fold. And we'll put this behind you, so we still have this feeling of opening our upper back, and we'll take the other blanket, which is pretty much still folded in half, and we'll put that at the top. Okay, so go ahead, Fitzjoy, lie down. And we'll put the bolster on top of the legs. Look how cute you are. Oh. All right, and then draw your shoulders down and away from your ears. Okay, so let the bolster be on the legs for grounding, for heaviness, okay? Right, now once again, just continuing to observe your breath and the patterns that the breath has. Okay, so for some of us, the breath resides only in the chest, and this is known as more anxious breathing. And see if you can start to drop the breath down into the abdomen. So it's a soft breath, and this breath is usually what happens when we're sleeping or when we're deeply relaxed. And just connect to the pause at the base of the exhale as well. Good. Here, we'll put the other pulse in. And then go ahead and take another long exhale. Let yourself be empty. And then inhale, filling up slowly. Holding at the top. And exhale to the base of the sternum. Exhale to the navel. Exhale completely. And then just let your breath be soft and easy. And exhale completely. Inhale, filling up. Try to get the breath into the armpit, chest, top of the chest. Hold. Exhale, one third. Exhale to the navel. Exhale completely. Breathing in and out. And exhale all the breath. One more time. Inhale, filling up slow. Holding. Exhale, one third. Halfway. Completely. Notice that empty space. And then just let yourself breathe more natural. And also continue to be in that place where you're observing. You're observing, thinking less. Just letting everything be. And it's a place where things can settle. And go back to more of an active breath, deeper breathing. Continue to connect to your inner space. And then exhale all the breath. Inhale one third to the navel. Halfway to the base of the sternum and completely from the thoracic to top chest. And exhale. And once again, just natural breaths. These are also recovery breaths. And exhale. Notice the pause. Let your tailbone drop. Inhale, one third. Halfway. All the breath in. And exhale. Once again, just breathing in and out, natural. And exhale. Last time, inhale one third. Halfway. Completely. observe your breath. Let it flow naturally. Perhaps even observe your energy more balanced, your mind calmer. Just continue to connect to that quiet place that's inside. It's always there. Take a couple deeper breaths. Gently wiggle the fingers, wiggle the toes. I'm going to take the bolsters off. Sorry, they're a little on. Go ahead and bend the knees. She was asleep right between your legs. Roll over to your right side. And go ahead and just press yourself up for just a little bit. You can keep the blanket that was here for your head, but take the threefold out. And Fitzjoy, go ahead and lie on your back again. And you'll bend your knees. And put the bolster between your legs and take your heels up off the floor. Good, I'm gonna put the bolster like that. And then bend the knees slightly and exhale, shimmy the hips to the left and drop the knees to the right. Good. And then reach your left arm out to the side. And just moving in, you could reach it back a little bit. And just moving into a gentle twist. And put your right hand onto your left thigh. Good, and lengthen the top of the hip down. Okay, so just a minute here, just to release the low back. So we're just gonna go into one more restorative, legs at the wall. Okay, however, if you are short on time, you're welcome to end your practice here in Lying Shavasana. If you'd like to continue onwards to the legs at the wall in meditation, we have a little bit more time. Okay. And then go ahead and twist to the other side. Yay. She's deeply relaxed. Go ahead and slowly bring your legs back to center. Good. And then I'll take the bolster and roll over to your right and press yourself up. You could do me a favor and just move that blanket right there. Look how sweet. And we're going to take legs at the wall. So go ahead and set yourself up. Okay. Do you need the strap?
Yeah.
So usually I like to get my butt really close to the wall, put the legs up at the wall, and then do the bolster. But people do it different. I think you do it different, right? Okay, so we'll watch how Fitzjoy does it. Do you need anything else? Do you want, and you have the blanket with him. This puppy is way too cute. I can't move to disturb the puppy sleeping. Do you want the blanket for your head? Okay.
had to strap my bolster to the here. Can I get the other bolster?
And so a lot of times I found for tight hamstrings, this works to put another bolster. So if you watch what he's doing, sometimes people put the bolster between their legs, they put it on the back of the thighs. Okay. I think if you're flexible, you don't need that second bolster though. Very good. And then we'll put the eye pillow on. And we'll be here for about 10 minutes as well. So go ahead and settle in.
Put the block onto my feet.
And okay, that means I have to stand up. Hold on. Excuse me, little one. Mommy, I'll be back. Okay, and if you do have weight, like a sandbag, or I'm putting blocks here. So I find yoga is always better when you practice with a friend or a partner. Okay. Especially when we're at home, you can help each other out. So go ahead, and once you are settled into the pose, take a deep breath and a long exhale. And just continue to observe the weight of your legs descending. So the muscles of the thighs, they get overworked throughout our day. Especially when we're rushing, these muscles of the psoas and the hip flexors, they get really tight because of stress. So putting the legs above the heart is a really nice way to soften these muscles. Increase more circulation in the organs too. So deeply restoring this pose. It's a Viparita Karani. And then just continue to let the back of the head be heavy. So your brain relaxes, your brain slows down. And we can really think from a clearer place when our brain slows down. Fear amps everything up. When we move into that place of slowing down, we can operate more from discernment. So just notice the subtleties of the breath coming in, the breath going out, letting the tongue relax, the jaw relax, and just all these subtle places inside we might hold tension. As you get quiet, get in touch with these places and give them permission to let go, to soften. Be with it all right now. back to your breath. Take the blocks off your feet. And wiggle the toes a little. And then slowly slip your legs out of the strap. I'm going to let you do that. And then bend the knees out to the side like a Baddha Konasana. Just let the back of the pelvis relax. And when you're ready, slowly roll to your right, or for you, the left, I guess. And press yourself up. And have a seat back onto the bolster. We're going to do a very brief meditation. So making sure your hips are higher than the knees. Sit on as many blankets as you need. Lifting the upper back so the chest is buoyant. You can bring the palms up or down on your knees, or sometimes cupping the hands in Dhyana Mudra, right over the left is nice. Sitting up tall, closing the eyes, just letting the effects of this practice settle. Notice the quieting of the nervous system. And begin to observe the natural flow of your breath, just gently moving in and out. Observe the natural pauses between your inhales and exhales. And see if you can just stay with this natural flow of breath, of prana, pure energy just moving in and out. Continue to let the eyes recede. So the external environment and any stimulus in the external environment, it fades away. As you focus and draw your attention inwards to that inward space. Thoughts come, just notice them and come back to your breath. Drop your awareness down into your heart space. Just notice this area, just receiving the breath. And just silently repeating this mantra and letting it reside in your heart. May all beings everywhere know happiness and peace. May we reside in better alignment where we live in community and help each other. May we all live from a place that's deeply connected to our heart. Connected connected to the planet and one another. And then join your palms, lifting the heart, bowing the head, honoring the heart space. Go in peace. Namaste.
Namaste.
Thank you. Thank you, my love.